everyone. In this video, we will cover the current affairs. I am Nuzhat Sana. For mobile optimized ebooks, please install GK Today Academy app. You can attend the quizzes on this app for better practice. And after that, you can also read the detailed explanation of the questions you have missed. For regular updates, please check our Telegram channel. The link is given in the description box. You can subscribe to it if you find it relevant. For hard copy books, you can visit our website gktbooks.com. Okay. Also, our latest initiative is UPSC Prelims Test Series for 2021 and 2022 in GK Today Academy app. So if you are appearing in UPSC prelims, you may consider joining this. So now without wasting any further time, let's get started. So today we'll be discussing most important MCQs for 31st of May 2021. Starting with very first question, what is UHI that the government is set to launch under the National Digital Health Mission? So what is it? So before knowing UHI, you have to know what is NDHM, that is National Digital Health Mission. So this has been launched by Prime Minister on occasion of 74th Independence Day. And this mission is a part of three digital announcements. First is NDHM itself. Then second was new cyber security policy. And the last one is optical fiber connection. So NDHM is a government entity that seeks to develop an integrated digital type of health infrastructure. Okay, and under this mission, all Indians will receive health IDs that will store the person's medical records, like how many times he has visited to doctor or how many diseases has he suffered from, then which type of drug is he taking, right? So these type of records would be stored with this ID. Okay. So finally, government has decided to fast track the expansion of operations under this mission, and it is set to launch a UHI, that is Unified Health Interface, which will enable people to use the digital platform for hosting health services, including all type of online medical consultations, and you can also book your place for laboratory test. Okay. So basically, it is a government initiative to make the health system little more digital. Okay. Question number 2, which molecule is the genetic material of the SARS-CoV-2 virus? First of all, what is the full form of this? It means severe acute respiratory syndrome coronavirus. See, currently, whatever COVID-19 vaccines have been made, they use mRNA. Here, M stands for messenger RNA, okay? So as to teach human immune system to recognize this virus. But recently, scientists in Taiwan have developed a new DNA-based COVID-19 vaccine that successfully induced antibodies against this coronavirus in mice and hamsters. What is hamster? It is also a kind of rodent, okay? So as we know that viruses have either RNA or DNA as their genetic material. So earlier we used to make COVID-19 vaccine with RNA, but now scientists of Taiwan have developed these vaccines with the help of DNA. Okay. So that's why this thing is in news. And here correct answer is RNA, because till now we made all COVID-19 vaccines with the help of RNA. Fine. Question number 3. Sang Yin Hung, who became the world's fastest woman to scale the Mount Everest, belongs to which country? So this lady was in light. Why? Because she is just 44 years old and she has made this record by scaling the Mount Everest in 25 hours and 50 minutes, which is itself a record, and she belongs to Hong Kong. Now one more personality, you would have heard about this name, Arthun Moir, because he is the oldest American to climb world's highest peak, which is 8848 meters. Now, can you identify which peak is this we are talking about? And also, apart from it, last year we have heard about the name Satyarup Siddhant. Why? Because he has made record and entered his name in Lemka Book of Records. Why? Because he is the first Indian to climb highest volcanoes in the world of all 7 continents. Okay? So, he is the first person to do this type of thing. And also, there was one more lady, Bhavna Deharia. Why her name is important? Because she has successfully scaled Mount Kosciuszko, which is the highest mountain peak of Australia. Fine. So you need to remember all these mountaineers. Now question number 4, which country has officially recognized the Namibia genocide and offered a financial support? So this country is Germany, and for the very first time in history, Germany has accepted that it committed genocide against people present there in Namibia during its colonial rule. And when was it? A century ago, okay? So between 1904 to 1908, German colonial settlers killed people there, and mostly from Herero and Nama tribes. So you need to remember the name of this tribe as well. And why they killed them? Because they rebelled against this colonial rule, okay? And after 5 years of negotiation, finally Germany has accepted that yes, they have committed this type of genocide on a mass level, and now they have promised that they will provide financial support to Namibia and give them more than €1 billion to help community projects there in Namibia, okay? Now few days back, there was a festival which was in news, Oktoberfest. What is it? So it is a type of annual festival which is celebrated in the month of October where at Germany. But now due to COVID-19 pandemic, it has been cancelled. And yes, it was cancelled last year as well, okay? And 2-3 lectures back, we have studied about a panel called as One Health High Level Expert Panel. What is it? It is an initiative of France and Germany, and it was formed by WHO along with 3 other organizations. And why it has been made? So as to prevent spread of diseases from animal to humans, okay? So to avoid this, the panel has been created, and here also Germany was involved, okay? Now question number 5, action and investment in menstrual hygiene and health is the theme of which special day celebrated on May 28th? So actually on May 28th, we celebrate our World Menstrual Hygiene Day. And why only 28, not 27, 26 or 29? Because this 28 represent the menstrual cycle. As we know that menstrual cycle is of 28 days. And menstrual period is of 5 days almost. So to represent this menstrual cycle, 28 May has been chosen to celebrate our World Menstrual Hygiene Day. And this year theme was action and investment in menstrual hygiene and health, okay? And this day was initiated first of all by German non-profit WASH United. In which year? In 2013. And why we celebrate this day? So as to spread some awareness about it, because lot of people still think that this is something which the girls should hide from men. No matter how much they are in pain, they still have to do work. And they have to hide their napkins as well. But now it's time to create awareness about it. It's just a part of life, okay? Talking about some more days. A very important day is NRI Day. And we celebrate this day on 9th of January. Why? Because on this day, Gandhiji came back to India from South Africa in 1915. So that's why we celebrate this day as NRI Day, which is also called as Pravasi Bharatiya Divas. And we celebrate our World Youth Day on 12th of January. Now can you tell me on this day, the birthday of which important personality is there? Do let me know in the comments. And also one more question for you. You have to tell me, when do we celebrate World Environment Day? Now one hint from my side, this day is celebrated in the next month, just after May, okay? Question number 6, who chairs the GST Council meeting? So this meeting was headed by our Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman. So this was 43rd GST meeting, and it was conducted through video conferencing. And in this meeting, the decision over tax rates on COVID vaccines was referred to a group of ministers. And also, it has been decided that quarterly returns for small traders will continue, but they have provided now relaxation of the late fees penalty for the payment of GST. Okay. So earlier what happened was, if there is late payment of GST, then there was a penalty upon it. But now there is no penalty and you do not have to pay extra amount. Okay. Now apart from it, there was one more summit, Global G20 Health Summit. The question is, who has hosted it? So it has been hosted by European Union along with Italy. Fine. Question number 7. what is the objective of the Yuva program launched by the Prime Minister recently? First of all, what is the full form of this acronym Yuva? It means young, upcoming and versatile authors. So sometimes what happens is, if you remember only the full form of acronym, then you would be able to know and at least guess it that with what thing it is related to. Okay? So it has been launched by Ministry of Education, and with this acronym, you can know that the correct answer is B option here, author mentorship. So basically it is an author mentorship program to train young authors who are below the age of 30 years. And this program is a part of India at the Rate 75 project. And those young writers would be promoted with this who have themes like unsung heroes, freedom fighters, or some type of forgotten places. So here those authors and writers would be mentored as well as promoted. Fine. Few days back we have heard about the scheme called as Samvedna. So it was a program launched to remove the stress and fear level among the students or children. Why? Because they are afraid of COVID-19. Okay. Now you have to tell me the full form of this acronym. I need to know how much you remember it. So do write your answers in the comment section. Question number 8. Which country holds the BRICS 2021 chairship? Now if you remember, I have told you that from 2021, BRICS chairship has come to India. And now India will host all the events related to BRICS this year. Okay. So here correct answer is option number B. And this is the third time that India will be hosting this event. And earlier it had hosted it in 2012, then 2016, and now in 2021. Fine. Recently, you would have heard about second BRICS Sherpas and SOS Sherpas. What is it? This meeting was convened by India to prepare for upcoming meeting of BRICS foreign minister. Okay. And theme of this event was BRICS at the Rate 15, intra-BRICS cooperation with continuity, consolidation and consensus. So this was the theme for this year. Okay. And what are BRICS countries? It's Brazil, Russia, India, China and South Africa. South Africa is the latest country which has joined this group. And now you have to tell me in which year South Africa has joined it. Okay. And BRICS was also in news because first ever BRICS employment working group meeting was held virtually. And again, India was host for it. And in this meeting, various issues related to working group were discussed, like part of women in labor force, then how to formalize our labor markets. These were the issues which have been discussed here. Okay. So from now, please remember that this year, all the BRICS event would be hosted by our India. Okay. Now question number 9, the National Artificial Intelligence Portal is an initiative of which union ministry? First of all, why this portal is in news? Because it has celebrated its first anniversary on 28th of May 2021. And the name of the portal is indiaartificialintelligence.gov.in. So this portal is related to Ministry of Electronics and IT, and it is not part of only this ministry, but there are other as well, like NASCOM and National E-Governance Division. Okay. And this portal serves as a central hub for all the artificial intelligence related news, learning articles, or whatever event activities are taking place across the world. And during this virtual event, a report titled 1 year of India AI was unveiled, and also a new look of website homepage was also generated. Fine. Now few days back, Government of India has launched an online portal. Why? To procure telecom gears from the trusted sources. So how to identify which one is trusted source? So it would be identified by highest cyber security offices. Okay. And our Minister for Electronics and IT is Ravi Shankar Prasad. Question number 10, where is Indian Immunological Limited located? So why it is in news? First of all, because central government has provided grants to some public sector companies under Mission COVID Suraksha. Why? So as to increase our vaccination production. Okay. And as per Science and Technology Ministry, IIL and Bharat Biotech, they have collaborated together to supply drug substance for manufacturing of Covaxin, and it is located at Hyderabad. Last year, Hyderabad was in news. Why? Because it ranked 16th in CCTV surveillance, and it was held not only in India but at global level. Okay. Question number 11. What is the sharing pattern between the center and the northeastern states in the midday meal scheme? See, first of all, what is midday meal scheme? It is a program designed to ensure a better nutrition of school age children in India. Okay. And under this scheme, free lunches are provided on working days in a school for all the children who are studying in primary level or upper primary level. And this scheme is covered by National Food Security Act 2013. Now what happened is, under this scheme, both center and state government share cooking cost for daily meals. Okay. And what is the ratio for it? It is 60:40 for all the northeastern states plus our union territories who have legislatures. Okay. And in this, Jammu Kashmir does not come. And for all other states, it is 90:10. Okay. So recently, center has decided to share its part of cooking cost completely in midday meal scheme for students of classes 1 to 8 into their bank accounts as one time COVID relief. Okay. So that's why this thing was in news. Do remember little background of it as well. Question number 12. Where is the headquarters of NCC located? So first of all, NCC is a youth wing of IAF, that is Indian Armed Forces. Okay. And recently, Defense Secretary has launched Directorate General 2.0 NCC mobile training app version. Why? Because this app will assist in conducting online training to NCC cadets during this COVID-19 pandemic condition. Okay. And last year, NCC was in news. Why? Because government has decided to expand it and has said that 1/3 of new cadets will be girls. So its headquarters lies in New Delhi. Fine. Question number 13. Which Indian personality has been removed as ambassador of Convention for the Conservation of Migratory Species of Wild Animals? So earlier this person used to be the ambassador of CMS, but now he has been removed. And who is he? It is Randeep Hooda. So first of all, CMS is United Nations Environment Treaty. And why he has been removed? Because recently Randeep Hooda has made derogatory comments against Bahujan Samaj Party chief Mayawati, and it comes into controversy, and that's why this decision has been taken. Okay. CMS is also called as Bonn Convention, and it is an international agreement signed in 1979. Why? So the aim of this organization is to conserve migratory species throughout the world or whatever is in their range. Now one more platform is there, Pravasi Rozgar. This platform is of Sonu Sood to help all the migrant workers or laborers who have lost their jobs in the COVID-19 pandemic. So this platform will help all that people to find some sort of job. Okay. Question number 14. The RBI fined which leading bank for irregularities found in its auto loan book? So recently RBI has imposed a monetary penalty of 10 crore rupees for this, and on which bank? It is HDFC. Why? Because RBI found that bank was in contravention of regulatory directions as mandated by Banking Regulations Act. So this decision has been taken because they have received a complaint from a whistleblower, and after examining, they found HDFC guilty, and the sale of third party non-financial products to the bank auto loan customer was going on. Okay. So that's why RBI has fined this bank. And RBI was also in news because it was to conduct first SLTRO for small finance banks. So we are revising this thing from past 2-3 days. You will forget it ever now. And also RBI has set up a committee to assist RRA under MD S. Janki Ram. Okay. Now coming to last question. What is the new name of the Indian Broadcasting Foundation, the top body of broadcasters? Actually, IBF has changed its name and now it is called as Indian Broadcasting and Digital Foundation. So as we know that everyone is rushing towards digital thing, so it is also expanding its scope to cover digital streaming by forming a self-regulatory body, that is DMCRC, which means Digital Media Content Registration Council. Okay, so this would bring broadcasters and the OTT, means over the top platform, under one range. Fine. So now let's start with today's quiz. Here on the slide you can see 5 questions present. You have to answer each of these questions and at the end of the video pin down your scores in the comments. Okay, so that's it for today. I hope you have liked the session. These were the important news and events from today, and tomorrow we'll meet again with some more important current affairs. Till then, stay tuned, and if you find the content useful, please hit the like button and also subscribe to GK Today. With this, Meenu Zarsana signing off.